Hello guys and gals, Tony here, and you are looking at Zoombinis Mountain Rescue, the second installment in the epic trilogy that is made by the Zoombinis. Wow, that was a horrible way of doing it. As you can see, I'll just give a background. So I've been trying to record this first episode for about 2 days, and obviously I've created 6 different games from this. The main problem was the cutscenes at the very beginning, which is why the first episode is taking a while, because the cutscenes are only in the first episode. So I had to record them separately on these two until they were both completely recorded, because what would happen is that you finish and get to a checkpoint and a cutscene happened, but on the playback the video didn't show the cutscene itself, it just froze. So I had to record the cutscenes independently, and now I'm going to have to edit those in for this first episode. So this episode would take up a lot of disk space on my drive, which I don't really need, and I'm wasting, not really wasting time, but I'm taking the time to explain it to you. So seriously, if there are any other cutscenes I need to know about, I want to know when they happen so I can plan ahead, so I can edit my video settings accordingly, and I don't have to like go through like 6 different playthroughs to get to the same spot and record the cutscenes there. So anyway, we are going to start completely new. I haven't really played this game at all until like these 6 tries, and so I have an idea of the puzzles now because I failed multiple times on recording. So we're just gonna create a new one, and then we're gonna make sure that, can I just rewrite it? I can't start the game. I can't delete the game. Alright, so new player. What it is. Alright, so I'll probably edit out the cutscene and put what I recorded on earlier, but whatever. I'll see you guys on the other side.
Once upon a time, there was a beautiful land of lush forests and clear, sparkling waters. And in this beautiful land lived a happy bunch of creatures known as the Zoombinis. The Zoombinis all looked a little different. Different hair, eyes, noses, and feet. But those differences meant nothing to the Zoombinis. They lived in peace and prosperity in the town of Zoombiniville. One Thursday morning, after a dark and fierce storm, a Zoombini named Binky ran into town and told the most alarming story. Binky was gathering strawberries with a group of his friends. As the group journeyed home, a great storm blew in out of the north. The frightened Zoombinis ran into a nearby cave for shelter. The Zoombinis were startled to find that they were surrounded by the strangest creatures. What could they be? Binky ran out of the cave. A bolt of lightning struck the cave's mechanical door. It trapped Binky's friends inside. Inside with the mysterious creatures. Binky tried with all his might to open the door, but it was just too heavy. Binky rushed home to Zoombiniville to get help. This terrible tale made the Zoombinis very worried. The caves were rumored to be in Bully territory. And although no Zoombini had ever met a Bully, they knew that Bullies were something to be feared. What if the strange cave creatures were Bullies? The Zoombinis have decided that a rescue party must be formed at once.
Sweet.
16 Zoombinis will journey to the caves and rescue their trapped comrades.
Aye.
And you, my friend, will lead them.
Woo.
The Zoombinis are counting on you.
Got
Choose
this.
The features of the first 16 Zoombinis. Mm. Or click on the numbers 1 or 16 and that many Zoombinis will be chosen for
Sweet.
You.
Sweet. So, you know me, randomize. So none of y'all can think, oh, he's just making this game easy on himself. We're just gonna do that. Yeah, buddy. As you can see, huge difference in graphic detail. I think they try to go to 3D aspect modeling, I guess, for graphics, which is, I mean, it's a step in the right direction. I don't know. I just somehow thought that the previous graphics were a lot better for the game. And so, we're just gonna go.
And so the intrepid Zoombinis set out to cross the water and reach the great caves. A family of turtles can help cross the stream. If the Zoombinis are in order, it works like a dream.
They're still rhyming, which is cool. I like that. It's definitely more like a adventure theme than sort of just like the first guy was kind of... Okay, I can't see that. Okay, so the first guy was kind of like a... I like the first guy. He was cool. And then this guy is like the more modern version, what we assume with adventure. So like a more friendly sort of young guide voice thing. Which, I mean, I guess is bound to happen. I just prefer the old guy because I was so used to him for like my entire childhood. Did I miss one? Yeah, I missed one. Nice. I click on him. So, this puzzle, if you guys haven't figured out already, is kind of like Lion's Lair, where I'm supposed to match features. And on the first difficulty, they just sort of give me the pattern they're supposed to be in, so I'm just kind of trying to talk my way through it without being too boring. But we're pretty much on with this level, so ready to move on. Neato! Neato. Everyone celebrates by... kind of look like having seizures, but whatever.
Well done! The Zoombinis are proud to have met their first challenge. Their courage is true, but now they must face the Pipes of Palu. A perfect match will help them slide right through.
Alright, so this is kind of like a Stone Rise if you ever only played the logical sense, where you're supposed to match features and then when all these pipes are blue, then I turn the main valve, and then we're done. So, we're just gonna start sticking people on. Sort of work from there. These two have the only same hair, so I guess they go here. Eyes, there are a lot of eyes to match up here. Nose color, we can do green noses, why not? As you can see, I'm sort of arbitrarily putting them on there, and then I'll just mix and match when I'm done. Which shouldn't take too long for a first difficulty playthrough. I honestly don't know what to expect with the second difficulties, so everything's gonna be a surprise after like the first party, really. That almost worked out. What can I do? And that should be it. And that is all 8 pipes flowing through, and then we turned a valve. Yay! And Zoombinis reveal their aqueous transformation, which is cool. I mean, if you can transform into water and just travel wherever, I guess for defense purposes, that's like impossible to just hunt them down pure water. But yeah, we're just gonna watch the first time and then skip the rest, I guess. And that's about it.
You've done it! The pipes took the Zoombinis on quite a ride. They came to a stop inside a mysterious cube, confused and unsure of just what to do. It seemed that escape was controlled by 3 levers, and rescue was waiting for those who were clever.
Alright, so if you're not from America, which is probably like 5% of you who watch my videos, levers, same thing as levers. So basically, after doing this puzzle like 20 times in my failed attempts, I kind of figured out what each lever does. So the idea is to not hit the spleen right here. And so these levers either go, well, I think I know them in order. So I think this one goes up and down levels, and then this one goes to and from me. So kind of like to and from me, and then these ones go right to left. So if we were to see, okay, I think this one's right to left. So, okay, that's to and from me, I guess, which is cool. It doesn't really matter. This one's to and from me. This one is... what doesn't really matter? This one's up and down. So, to up and down, to and from me, left and right, up and down, to and from. And we're done. I guess the lever positions change with every puzzle, so that's going to be hard to figure out the first time.
Huzzah! The Zoombinis have been saved from the waves. They can now safely journey to their friends in the caves.
So here comes the cutscene. I'll see you guys on the other side of it. Not much else to say. See ya.
The Zoombinis worked together, and their combined weight caused the mechanical door to open. They watched in delight as their trapped friends emerged from the darkness. The Zoombinis were reunited. But what's this? Not all of the Zoombinis have been accounted for. A Zoombini named Zua explained why. When the storm came, the Zoombinis ran into the cave for shelter. Huddling in the darkness, they heard a strange rustling nearby. In a flash of lightning, the Zoombinis saw that the strangest creatures were watching them. It was the mysterious Boolies. In a panic, the Zoombinis scattered in every direction. Just at that moment, lightning struck, and the door closed with a thud. Some of the Zoombinis found their way back to the door of the cave, but the others? They must still be inside, inside with the Boolies. Another rescue party must be formed, this time to search the dark and mysterious caves. Only the 8 most intrepid Zoombinis will be chosen for this most dangerous assignment.
Alright, so if you guys haven't figured out, so this is the first checkpoint. And so these spots indicate the Zoombinis' placement, and we need 8 to cross this time, which is different from the 16 I'm used to. But we still have 2 paths that sort of diverge to different sets of levels.
8 brave Zoombinis have chosen to go left, but the Hall of the Scarabs has stopped them in their tracks. The doors of the Scarabs are closed up in stone and can only be opened if the Scarab is home.
Alright, so we gotta match the color of the Scarab with the color of the circle, and then we can pull this lever and open the door. And 4 can go across, so I have to do this puzzle twice and the puzzle changes. So the first set isn't too bad. So, let's see. Which way does it rotate? That way. So swap out with that, and then I need... So that was in order. I need to swap the green one. No. Yes. No, these should be fine, I think. I guess I'll have these 2 up here. Okay. Whoops. All the way around. And... damn it. So we gotta go all the way around again. Swap it out. And all the colors are lit up. See? There we go. So that's 4. And the second one is always randomized, so I guess I have to figure out what to do here. So the blue one's already here. I don't know if I want to mess with that. I need to somehow switch these 2. Oh wait, that was really easy.
Good job!
Yeah.
The Zoombinis emerged from the cave to find a village draped in snow. There they met the friendly but demanding Norfs. These furry creatures offered the Zoombinis safe passage through their town, but only after lunch. To make each Norf happy and to pass through their borders, feed each hungry Norf all the food that it orders.
So this level from a logical journey game is kind of like Pizza Pass, except it's sort of less repetitive, and instead of doing just one topping at a time, I can just click on them and they'll tell me a clue. And I'm supposed to figure out, and I can use this chart to mark on it whether they like it, don't like it, or I don't know, to clear it. And then it's easier for me, so I can narrow it down. It's kind of like a matrix, I guess. So let's just go.
I don't want salad.
So I can mark no salad for you.
The person who wants salad is not sitting next to the one who wants fish.
So that's kind of meh.
Nobody wants milk or tea.
So nobody wants milk or tea. So everybody wants orange juice. They can only have 1 drink and 1 entree. So that was a big clue. So that's 50% done.
One of my neighbors and I want a sandwich.
So he wants a sandwich. He doesn't want that or that.
The person who wants salad is not sitting next to the one who wants fish.
Okay, so the person who wants salad isn't sitting one next to the person who wants fish. So for example, if the orange guy liked fish, that would mean this guy would have to be a sandwich, this guy has to be a sandwich, but this guy's a salad, which contradicts each other. So I know he doesn't want a fish.
One of my neighbors and I want a sandwich.
So
the person who wants salad is not sitting next to the one who wants fish.
So these two can't have salad or I'm just gonna mark it down here. No, that's not right. This is what I wanted.
One of my neighbors and I want a sandwich.
The person who wants salad is not sitting next to the one who wants fish.
I don't want salad.
Okay, yeah, so he's fish and salad. So he doesn't want salad. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is right.
Okay, some of you can go.
So for each one you get right, two Zoombinis can make it across. So sandwich, anyone wants orange juice. And so, I guess it goes to either one.
Okay.
So then, orange juice and another sandwich.
Thank you, I was starving.
And last but not least, salad and orange juice, which I guess is a healthy breakfast or lunch drink, so it's pretty healthy.
Mmm, that was delicious!
And the Zoombinis smiled at the happily chewing Norfs, satisfied with a job well done.
And that's that level.
Having fed the Norfs a nutritious lunch, the Zoombinis gathered in the village square.
So another cutscene's coming up.
In the snowy village, the Zoombinis were at last reunited with their lost friends. They were also surrounded by a host of small purple creatures. Could these be the fearsome bullies? Huddled in the caves that stormy night, the Zoombinis heard a strange rustling. In a flash of lightning, the Zoombinis saw that the strangest creatures were watching them. Bullies! Just at that moment, the cave door slammed shut. The Zoombinis scattered in every direction. Griff and his friends tried to run, but bumped right into the bullies. Such unusual creatures. Some were smiling and some were not, and they liked to stick together like glue. The bullies led them out of the cave and to the safety of a snowy village. A very helpful thing for the mysterious bullies to do. Why, the bullies were nothing to be feared at all. Even the ones wearing frowns were very friendly. The Zoombinis greeted their new friends and began thanking them for their rescue. But just at that moment, one bully stepped forward and told a sad story. Last night, a terrible storm swept through their home, a town called Bullywood. The storm scattered the bullies throughout the land. The mayor of Bullywood, the Grand Bully Bully, was gone, and there was no one to gather them together. The bullies were confused and unsure of what to do. The Zoombinis came up with a plan. "We'll help you," the Zoombinis exclaimed. "We will journey on to Bullywood, gathering up bullies as we go." All the Zoombinis agreed that this was an excellent plan and prepared for their journey to Bullywood. It's time for another rescue party to be formed, this time to help the bullies. 8 Zoombinis will be needed for this journey.
So yeah, so now our quest turns from rescuing our fellow Zoombinis to helping out the bullies, who are not so bad as we thought. So we need a party of 8 to go to the last leg, which we have, so we're just gonna go.
So the Zoombinis resolved to head into the valley below. The only way down was a slippery path indeed, a ski slope controlled by grumpy Norfs. The Zoombinis' traits show them which way to travel. Don't run into Norfs or their plans may unravel.
So basically, you follow this tree diagram of where certain features go. So for example, if someone had sleepy eyes, they would go down this path by default, and then another segregation occurs here. And so the first time across, there's no obstacles, so you can just send whatever you want down. So that guy's gonna go there and all the way down. And then similarly, I'll just send her down. So now I need someone who's sleepy-eyed and with this kind of hair, which is this guy. So now I want someone who's not as sleepy-eyed, but has that kind of hair, which is just this one. And so now a sleepy-eyed non-haired, that hair, I guess. I don't know what to call that hair. Jelly curls, I guess. So then, everyone else is an other, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. So everyone else should just fit down here. I don't think they make this puzzle impossible on the first difficulty, so... yeah, we're good, we're good. Shredding down the powder. Hey, this is freaking me out, because that's weird.
Hurrah! Hurrah! The Zoombinis have made it down the mountain of snow, down to the much warmer valley below. There along the river, the Zoombinis met up with more groups of bullies. Only happy groups are willing to travel in the Zoombinis' borrowed boats. Some bullies are happy and others will brood. When hit with a pinball, they change up their mood.
Alright, so I'm guessing this one's gonna be the hardest of them all. So basically, I've done this level enough times, like once. So basically, for this difficulty at least, when you hit a sad bully, he changes to happy. Now, if you hit a pinball with the happy bully, it also flips his neighbor to the other one. So for example, if one was happy and one was sad, and you hit one pinball into the happy one, the sad one turns into a happy one, and the happy one turns into a sad one. So, I have one pinball, so I want to change this one to a happy one, so Vinny can make it across safely. Okay, so it doesn't really matter where I go for this one, so I'm just gonna go down here. Similarly for this one. And so now I can just send one down whatever path I want. So we're gonna do that. So let's think about three pinballs. So it's gonna make him happy and transform. The second one's gonna come. So to make him sad, happy, and the third one's gonna make him happy. So this should work. And boom, it goes. So I think that's 3 out of the 8 so far. So then this one will be... yeah, this should work. So that should be 4. So it doesn't really matter which one. I go down here. First come, first serve. It's my motto. Let's do this. So happy, flip, happy. So it doesn't really matter which path I take, so... yeah. happy, flip, happy. This level's gonna be a pain. A harder difficulty, I can just tell. At least they could make it really, really hard for me. Is that everybody?
And the happy bullies all jumped into boats. Much happier boats than the boats of the blokes. And with the Zoombinis, they journeyed not alone toward the grand bully city that they called their home. Finally, the Zoombinis arrived in Bullywood with many happy bullies in tow. Looking around, they saw that Bullywood was deserted. The bullies explained that without their mayor, the grand bully, they could not stay together for long. They asked the Zoombinis to please help them bring more bullies home to Bullywood. Only then would the grand bully return. Bullywood needs more bullies, and to get them there, another group of Zoombinis must be formed.
So yeah, this is kind of what's going on in Bullywood, as it were. It's like a hotel, some kind of monument, sacrificing to the great god of Bully. This is like to be a factory of some sort where bullies can earn money and purchase stuff for like a haunted bully house and a restaurant of candy. And a roller coaster for the kids. So that's pretty much the first party. So let's just go back to the map, I suppose. So this is what we got so far. As you can see, the difficulty didn't increase right away. I don't know when that's gonna happen because I haven't gotten past like the first level of anything. Because you know, whatever. You know what I mean? Sort of video malfunctions and stuff like that. So. I'm really enjoying this game. Obviously being a logical journey to Zoombinis kind of guy, I have my personal favorite, but I can see that the learning company sort of, they kind of mess with the graphics a bit in a way, but in terms of fun levels that make me think at times, I can tell this is going to be one that's going to make me think quite a bit. So they've done a good job with that. And so again, leave comments, you know, advice. If you know what's going to go down, so I can be prepared or not make you guys mad when a cutscene goes horribly wrong. That's kind of what I'm going to do. If a cutscene goes horribly wrong, you're going to get the audio, but you may not get the video. Now, if it's so far into the playthrough that I would have to send another 600 Zoombinis across to get the same cutscene, and I don't know that the cutscene's going to happen, I'm sorry. I just can't. That's just... I can't do that with my busy schedule, especially when the summer I'm going to be completely busy. To the point where I might not be able to record videos in the summer. So, that's just a note, and I'm stating explicitly now that I'm sorry for future cutscene failures. It would be nice if people told me, or can send me some information on where to find when cutscenes happen. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed watching. I will edit this video and upload it as soon as I possibly can, and I will see you guys next time.